From the outside, Brazil looks vast, tropical, and scenic. The powdery, white sanded beaches, the beautiful women, the verdant rainforests, the soccer enthusiasts, and the exotic fruits all create a colorful image in our heads of the Samba Nation. From 2000 to 2012, Brazil was one of the fastest growing major economies in the world. However, Brazil's economy's growth decelerated in 2013, and the country entered a recession in 2014. That lasted until 2016. Tourism in Brazil has become a major industry. Cities like Rio de Janeiro and São Paulo have become two of the most visited destinations in the country. It began to boost in the early 2000s as a result of a strong devaluation of the American dollar against the Brazilian real, which made Brazil an expensive international destination. Revenues from international tourism continued to grow from $3.9 US in 2005 to $4.9 billion in 2007. Unfortunately, this trend changes when Brazil suffered a slowdown between 2008 and 2009, when both revenues and visitors fell as a result of the global economic crisis. By 2014, the industry recovered, particularly due to the international events such as the 2014 World Cup and the 2016 Olympics. Culture of Brazil is historically one of the principal bases of Brazil's economy. While it initially focused was on sugarcane, Brazil eventually became one of the largest exporters of coffee, soybeans, beef, and crop-based ethanol. It has the second largest number of cattle in the world after India, and the world's largest producer and second largest beef exporter. As a matter of fact, in 2009, Brazil had about 106 million hectares of undeveloped fertile land. Despite the financial crisis the rest of the world was going through, Brazil had a record agricultural production, with growths of 9.1% principally motivated by the favorable weather. The country had moved away from being the net importer of agricultural products to by then be the record world's fifth largest agriculture producer and exporter. In 2009, agriculture accounted for 19.3% of the world's labor force, or 19 million people, thus strongly a contribution to the poverty reduction. Brazil's top imports are refined petroleum, vehicle parts, $4.83 billion, packaged medicaments, $3.28 billion, telephones, $3.04 billion, and the crude petroleum, $2.9 billion. Talking about numbers, in 2000, the total number of imports was 55,851, and the export was 55,119. Later in time, specifically in 2013, the total value of export increased to 242,033, and the import increased to 239,748. The election of Brazil to host the World Cup in 2014 came 2 years before the global economic crisis. However, since its election as the host country in 2007 up to 2011, there were a continuous decline in the rate of unemployment. There was a necessity of workers in the construction sectors. According to Banca Itaú, one of the most important in Brazil, the economic effect of the World Cup were estimated to have a positive impact of 1.5 percentage points of the country's GDP over the next 3 years, which meant a boost of $35 million in the economy. With the creation of at least 255,000 jobs, when a direct investment is made for a cup, it has the effect of multiplying in the economy, they explained. Sadly to say, the same high expectations were set for the Olympics, supposed to create a bigger expansion of the Brazilian economy in the long term. Thank you. Brazil is going through its worst recession ever registered. Brazil's economy contracted 8 consecutive quarters. The country's GDP shrank 3.8% in 2015 and 3.6% in 2016, only having shown some growth in the first quarter of 2017. So what went wrong? As the recession hit the global economy, the government of Dilma Rousseff kept spending in order to delay its impact. What was the result of this? Debt grew, inflation rose, unemployment went up, leaving 13 million people unemployed. What about Dilma's impeachment? She has been accused of borrowing money from banks in order to cover up budget gaps, giving impression that government finances were still in top shape. Moreover, critics believe she was trying to plug deficit holes in the popular social program to boost her chances of being re-elected in 2014. She has recently found herself in trouble by allegations of her own involvement in what may be the biggest corruption scandal in history. The situation of corruption in the country is said to be a major reason for slowing down Brazil's economy. For the past 3 years, Brazil has been gripped by the scandal which started the state-owned oil company Petrobras and grew to encapsulate more than 80 politicians and members of business elite, including Brazil's extremely popular former president Lula and the current president Michel Temer. In what has been called the Operation Car Wash, involving companies such as the big construction conglomerate Odebrecht. Brazil's troubles began with the downturn in the global commodity market, which once boasted the country. Brazil is the largest economy in Latin American region, and it is also the major exporter of commodities such as iron ore. Iron ore's price fell by 50% at the beginning of 2016 due to reduced demand from China. Agricultural exports have also suffered in the last 2 years due to several droughts. Reduced production bumped prices of commodities such as soybeans and corn, but overall businesses were hurt due to the reduction of export affecting the companies in the sector. As of 2016, Brazil has become the 21st largest exporting economy in the world, and the 42nd most complex economy according to the Economic Complexity Index. In 2016, Brazil exported 182 billion and imported 135 billion, resulting in a positive trade balance of 46.4 billion. In 2016, the GDP of Brazil was 1.8 trillion and its GDP per capita was 15.1k. The top export destinations are Brazil and China, the United States, Argentina, the Netherlands, Germany. The top imports origins are United States, China, Germany, Argentina, and France.
For all the international excitement that the FIFA World Cup brings, it's also brought a lot of criticism in Brazil. Some find it hard to digest the billions of dollars being spent on construction when millions of people are struggling just to eat.
Everything seemed too good to be true. However, there were several problems the World Cup left behind. The construction of the stadiums and the creation of the urban transportation facilities came to an immense social cost for the Brazilian citizens. Those suffering from poverty were most affected by the social displacement caused by the evacuation of the favelas. It is estimated up to 1.5 million people were forced to abandon their residence with worthless compensation. As a result, the Brazilian public has been the one most prejudiced. The government never delivered the second infrastructure projects it promised, such as the urban transportation facilities. It has also neglected the demands of society to provide healthcare, education, As we see, the World Cup and Olympic came at the direct expense of the Brazilian government and society. Instead of portraying Brazil as a vibrant, rich, and diverse country, the expenditure on a stadium amounted to a $3.6 billion, which could have been better invested on urgent public necessities. In 2016, when Brazil held the Olympics, the economic crisis was taking place. This worsened things. At the end of the year, average per capita disposable income would be less than 7% than in 2014. The excellence of Brazil, with an economy on the rise, willing to organize the best World Cup of soccer, and with the most dazzling Olympic Games in history, is no longer the true Brazil. The hidden reality has broadened poverty. Brazil suffers from an increasing inequality between social classes. One of the main causes of poverty is the inequality of land tenure, which has been one of the politically controversial since the 1950s. Other causes of poverty in Brazil are the lack of access to formal education and training.